On the 4th of July, 1806, we set sail from the sweet Cove of Cork. We were sailing away with a cargo of bricks from a grand city hall in New York. What a mighty fine craft, she was rigged fore and aft. Lord, how the wild winds drove her. She stood several blasts, she had 27 masts, and it conquered the Irish Road. We had 1 million bikes of the best swag of wags. We had 2 million barrels of stone. We had 3 million sides of blind horses' hides. We had 4 million barrels of foam. We had 5 million hogs and 6 million ducks. 7 million barrels of porter. We had 8 million dials of night ghost town. And hold up the Irish Road. There was old Mickey Coote, who played hard on his flute when the ladies lined up for a set. He was too ill with skill for his sparkling quadrille, but the dancers were fluttered and bent. With his smart, witty talk, he was cock of the walk, and he rolled the dames under and over. They all knew at a glance when he took up his stance, but he sailed on the Irish Road. There was Jimmy McGurk, who was scared stiff of work, and a man from West Meath on the loan. There was Slugger O'Toole, who was drunk as a rule, and fighting Bill Tracy from Dover. And your man Mick McCann from the banks of the Bat was a skipper of the Irish Rover. We had sailed 7 years when the mainsails broke out, and our ship lost its way in the fog. And that whale of a crew was reduced down to two, just myself and the captain's old dog. And that ship struck a rock, oh Lord, what a shock. The boat, it was turned right over. Turned 9 times around, and the poor old dog was drowned. And the last of the Irish Rover.